Hi, today I'm going to show you how to create a new ligature for Fira Code, what process I use. I will be implementing this one. This one is not in the current version, so yeah, don't look at what issue is closed, it's not closed yet. So yeah, we'll be implementing this sequence, which is currently rendered as this, which is not ideal. Right, so the first thing that we do is we go to the Fira Code repository, so it's cloned in this folder here, and we open the source file, which is glyphs file. Glyphs 2 is the application that I use for edit this font. It's the application that was used to create the Fira Mono font, and basically this is where all the sources are stored. Okay, so the font is here, like you can see all the symbols that's in it. I have a custom search here that basically filters just ligatures with liga in the name. These are what I added to the font. I use this notation when yellow means my ligature and blue means something that was changed in the latest version. We are starting a new version, so the first thing we do, we mark everything in yellow. Okay, and we also need to go to the settings and bump a font version like that. Okay, if you save, basically what we have right now, nothing has changed, but we will have a new version for the font. Now we need to create a new glyph about which will store the graphics for our ligature for that one. Okay, to create it, we go to add glyphs, and here we must enter the name. The name, it actually follows a convention, which is basically symbols that ligature consists of, separated by underscore. So for in this case, it will be like less underscore equal another equal greater dot liga. So basically, this is a convention. Okay. So we generate that. We get here. It also automatically adds the glyphs that I type in here, all of them. We don't need them, so we just delete them. Now what do we do? So we already have something like that. We already have the same graphics but for three characters, so we're going to reuse that. To find it, we go not one. So it's basically probably this, yeah, less equal greater. Okay, so we have it here. So this is how it looks, and it basically exactly what we need, but shorter, right? So we just go here, copy everything, paste it here. Now what we need to do is we need to move this arrow and those bars to the left. The width of one character, this is a monospace font, is 600 units. You can see it here. So we basically need to move it by 600. So we do just that here, like that. Then we select those and we move those as well. Cool. Now basically we have the graphics that we need for the case of four characters. But the downside is, yeah, but this is, I just did that for the regular font widths. There are two widths in master file, the regular one and the bold one. Let me show you. I will show you an example of this, right? So this is a bold one, this is regular one. It's only two widths, but everything else is generated from these two by just interpolation. So lightweight, retina weight, it's all interpolated from those two. Now, what we have to do, we implemented the regular one, but we haven't implemented the bold one. If I switch to bold one, we have the same mess, which we need to clean up. Then we go here, we basically do the same, copy what we have here, everything we have here, insert it here, move it by 600 points, so the bold font have the same widths, right? This by 600 points, and voila. So we have basically both widths. The last thing we need to check is to check master compatibility. It basically shows that every item in the regular base, and every point actually, it corresponds to the same point in the bold base, right? So instead of like, it basically it means we have didn't mess it up. So if, for example, if I mess up the order of lines on this bar, it will be like that, which is messed up, and the interpolation wouldn't work. So just a mistake, and I would see it here. But I didn't make that mistake here, and everything looks fine. If we turn this off, we switch here. So basically, now we have the graphics we need, right? The last step is to link the graphics to the code that actually generates the solution. So if I type this, I should see this, right? Right now, what I would see is this, because we don't have to code for the four characters. We have the code for three characters. And this one just a regular less symbol. So to do that, we actually go to the font properties, the features tab, there's cult, which is contextual alternates. And here is some generated code that basically does the substitution, right? Let me find here, what we need is basically we need it's here. Okay. So I will show you how to change it by hand, and then we will just regenerate it by the script that I have. Okay, let's go to the text editor where it's handy to edit. So this one, what this snippet of code does, it actually replaces the sequence of less equal greater with this ligature here. And it's done in three steps. The first step is this, which replaces the first character with lig. Lig is actually just an empty glyph. There's nothing will be written here. Then it replaces second character with lig, and the third one is actually replaced with the ligature, right? So what we need to do is we need to add another equal in here. This is just the name, it doesn't matter what is here, right? Then we need to add another equal here. Here we need to add the fourth one, right? So the lig equal greater like that. Then this one is actually is gonna be like that. This one is gonna be like that. And this one is gonna be like that. So, okay, so let me just check. I might just align them so it's easier to read because it's like human edited, right? Okay, let's see. So less equal greater replaced by leak, less equal greater replaced by leak, and the last one is replaced with the ligature that we just dropped. So it looks fine. Let's see if I insert it in the beginning here and click compile. Let's see if it works. So there were no errors and the graphics actually apply, right? So if I type this, it's actually what we need. Okay, cool. But this is kind of like long way to do that and not actually sustainable if I have like more than 100 ligatures. So what we do instead, we save this font file, and I have this closure script that will run, open the glyphs file, which is basically just a text file actually, find all the ligatures, all the glyphs with name liga in them, and generate the snippet that I need to insert there. So if I run it, let me just run it. It's called cult. And basically it prints some statistics here, but what we're interested in this piece of code, which we need to copy and go in there, and instead of manually generated piece, it's basically the same, it will generate exactly the same code because there's like no options. We cut it out and replace it. Okay, now let's go check, basically save, click compile, see that it still works. Yeah, it still works. Okay. This still works. this still works, this still works, so well, it seems fine. Okay, let's save it. We have bold weight, normal weight, which is fine as well. Okay, this should be color blue. Again, save again. And now the last part that we need to do, we need to export the font, right? So we just go here, we produce the OTF file. Okay, I will change the destination here. I will just generate the library fonts. Basically, this is a place where I install Fira Code font. So what I generate OTF file here, and it will be exported to exactly to the place where, let's just wait. Actually, we can go to that place on our own and see the progress. Okay. Code file, which is only understood by this application, right? Nothing else works with that. But OTF is a standard format, open type format, which every operating system and every editor and everything else understands. Okay, so export is completed. We can see that all five weights were generated here, right? Not just two that we edited, but all five from interpolation, as I said. They look like the bold, the slide, this medium, this regular, this straightened. Okay, and now if we want to test, we need to restart our editor or any other application so it reloads the fonts. And if you go here, we can see that it now works. The old ones work too. So yeah, I think we did what we were supposed to do. Let's go to the changelog and this will work in progress. Let's record that we added this one, and we need the issue number, which is 392. Save that and go here. So basically what we changed is changelog file and some glyphs file. Okay, I do not commit OTF. You can actually see that, that glyphs is just text file, so Git actually can produce your changes. It's just not so easy to scroll. Okay, whatever. I do not commit the OTF and other generated files before I release a new version, and I plan to add more changes to that version, so not yet. We saw that how it's done, how to install them, basically. So here we just put message, edit this sequence, closes issue number 392, and that's it. Let's push. So that's it. That's how you add a new commit link here. This is basically how you add a new ligature to the Fira Code font. That's it. I hope it was interesting and helpful, and come back for more. I will have more.